Ramaya Rama Bhadraya Ramachandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pate Namaha. Ayodhya Kant, chapter number 80, The Road to Ganga. In the previous chapter, we saw that Bharata requests everyone to build a proper road from Ayodhya to River Ganga, and the ministers are moved by Bharata's exalted words, wherein Rama is supposed to be the king and Bharata himself would reside in the forest, that they promise Bharata that the skilled artisans and workers will do so. In this chapter, we get to see how the road is laid between Ayodhya and River Ganga. Verses 1, 2, and 3. Atha bhumi pradeshagnya sutra karma visharadaha svakarma abhirata shura kanaka yantrika tada. Karmantika stapataya purusha yantra kovidaha tata vardha kaya chaiva margino vraksha takshaka kupakara sudhakara vamshakarma krita tata samartha yecha drashtara purata te pratasthire. There marched in advance experts in the nature of soils, sinkers of wells, diggers of canals, dikes and ditches, miners, builders of boats, canoes and rafts, armed convoys, stone cutters, royal officials, makers of mechanical appliances, carpenters, hewers of wood, sappers and levelers, preparers of lime and brick, gypsies and woodsmen. Basically, Valmiki just wants to know that so many people volunteer to use their skills in the service of the Lord. So it is not that only priests can serve the Lord. Absolutely not. Whatever you know how to do, do it in the service of the Lord. Whatever you do, do it for the Lord. This is exactly what Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita 9:27. Yat karosi, yat ashnasi, yat juhosi dadasi yat, yat tapasyasi kanteya tat kurushva mad arpanam. Whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer or give away, and whatever austerities you perform, do that, O son of Kunti, as an offering to me. And the purport says that it is the duty of everyone to mold his life in such a way that he will not forget Krishna under any circumstance. Everyone has to work for the maintenance of his body and soul together, and Krishna recommends herein that one should work for him. So we are basically interested in the work portion, so I'm not going to read the rest of the purport. But these skilled laborers use their skill in the service of Lord Rama. So they are molding their lives in such a way that they never forget Rama under any circumstance. And this is precisely what Valmiki is asking us to do. It doesn't matter whether you are a priest, it doesn't matter whether you are a warrior or a shudra. All it matters is that you use your skill in the service of the Lord. Whatever you do it for the Lord. And in the previous chapter, the ministers of Ayodhya called all these workers as Bhaktiman, as devotees who are using their skill in the service of the Lord. And that's precisely what Valmiki is doing over here as well. You can see that people from all different facets of life are energetic and courageous and attentive in doing their jobs. They're all working together so that they can use their skills in the service of the Lord. Verse 4. Satu harshittam uddhesham jana ogho vipulah prayan ashobata mahavegha sagarasya iva parvani. Like a swollen ocean on a full moon day, the multitude of people proceeded joyfully with great speed to the appointed place. So it's pretty obvious that they wanted to go through the duties as soon as possible so that it would shorten the distance between them and Rama. And when they marched on to the banks of River Ganga, like a rolling sea when the moon draws her with a mighty force, they were all so excited. They're going to see Rama, their beloved Rama. And what's more glorious than that? Verse 5. Tesva varam samasthaya vartma karmani kovidha karanai vivida upetai purastad sampratasthire. Those groups who were skilled in the construction of roads took up their places with every kind of tool and departed ahead of others. Verse 6. Lata vali cha gulmamscha stanun ashmaneva cha janate chakrire margam chindanta vividhan druman. With various kinds of tools, they cleared away the trees, stumps, branches, creepers, saplings, and stones from the path. So they had multiple weapons and tools such as the spade and the axe and the crowbar and saw. And with all these, they make a road through the tangled woods. Somehow or the other, they have to reach Lord Rama as quickly and safely as possible. Verse 7. Avrakshesu cha desheshu kechit vrikshan aropeyan kechit kuthare tankai cha datre chindan kvachit kvachit. Some planted trees where there were none, some fell down the larger trees with axe, chisel, and scythe. Verse 8. Apare virana stambhan balino balavartaraha vidamanti sma durgani. Thalani cha tata tata. Some other strong men plucked the strong rooted tufts of fragrant virana grass. Some leveled the rough uneven ground. Verse 9. Apare apurayan kupan palm shubhi svabharam ayatam nimna bhagam stata kechit samam chakru samantata. Some filled the ruined wells and deep crevices with earth, while others made low-level grounds plain and wide on all sides. Verse 10. Babandur bandhaniyam cha kshodayan samchukshudus tada bibhidur bhedaniyam cha tamstan deshan narah tada. Some lay bridges over ravines, some cut channels to drain away the waterlogged spots, some pounded fine and stony ground. Verse 11. Achirena eva kalena parivahan bahu udakan chakrur bahu vida akaran sagara pratiman bahun. In a short time, they constructed many water reservoirs of different shapes capable of holding large volumes of water like the sea. Verse 12. Nirjaleshu cha desheshu kanayamasu uttaman udupanan bahuvidhan vedika parimanditan. Some transformed shallow pools into lovely tanks adorned with flight of steps and platforms to rest. Verses 13 and 14. Sasudha kutima talah prapushpita mahiruha mata udghushta dvijagana patak abhir alamkrita chandana udaka samsikta nana kusuma bhushita Bahav Ashobata Senaya Panta Svargapatha Upama. The highway for the army was paved smooth with its surface decorated with stone and mortar, while lovely trees heavy with flower and fruit lined the sides, from whose branches many an intoxicated bird sent forth its sweet melody. It was decked with banners and sprinkled with sandal water and strewn with flowers of every kind. It was charming to look at, like the pathway of the gods. Verses 15 and 16. Agnapya atha yatha agnyapati yuktah te adikrita nara ramaniyeshu desheshu bahusvadu faleshu cha yo nivesha tu abhipreta bharatasya mahatmanah bhuyatam shobhayam asur bhushabhir bhushana upamam. Those authorized ordered the artisans to perform their respective tasks. Thereafter, they selected lovely tracts of land filled with trees bearing varieties of sweet fruits as resting place for the great-souled Bharata and decorated them so splendidly that they looked like ornaments themselves. Verse 17. Nakshatreshu, prashishteshu, muhurteshu cha tadvida, nivesham sthapayam asur, bharatasya mahatmanaha. Men well versed in the study of planetary positions relating to auspicious constellations and auspicious times arranged various resting places at different times during the sojourn of the great souled Bharata. Verses 18, 19, and 20. Bahupamshu chayah chapi parikha parivaritaha tantra indra kila pratimah pratoli vara shobitaha prasada mala samyukta sauda prakara samvrita pataka shobita sarve sunirmita mahapatha Visharpatbir iva akashe vitanka agra vimanakai samuchritai niveshah te babhu shakrapura upama. They heaped sand and dug moats around the resting place. It was adorned with well-built highways and broad thoroughfares, lined with mansions surrounded by walls as high as Mount Indrakila. The peaks of those tall residences decorated with flags which looked as if spreading into the sky. Thus the resting place shone like the abode of Indra. Verse 21. Janavim tu samasadhya vivida druma kananam shitala amala paniyam mahamina samakulam. The roads reached Ganga with its cool and limpid waters abounding in large fishes, its bank lined with groves of various trees. Verse 12. Sachandra tara gana manditam yatha nabah kshapayam amalam virajate nara indra margasa tatha virajata Kramena Ramya Shubah Shilpi Nirmitaha. The lovely royal road constructed in an orderly fashion by eminent craftsmen looked splendid like the clear sky decorated with the moon and the cluster of stars. So basically in this chapter, Valmiki gives a very detailed description of the various types of events that took place in building a road from Ayodhya to River Ganga. We saw that the shallow pools were converted into lovely tanks. Some dug wells and lakes of delicious water where there was before but dry parched earth with broad steps down which might descend elephants, horses and men to slake their thirst. There were shady platforms nearby which invited them to rest their wearied limbs. The road by which the army was to travel was strongly built. It was very charming to look at. And an auspicious star was selected for everything. And the platform was very smooth sand and resembled mountains with precious gems. That is the Indrakila mountain. Then temples and royal mansions and broad courts grew under their skilled hands, and then spacious roads ran among them. There were gay flags and proud banners towered aloft. Stately mansions rose to the sky proudly and lent the encampment the air and grandeur of Amaravati, the metropolis of the Devas, or the cars of light that glide softly through the blue empyrean. We saw various such descriptions because Valmiki wants us to know that Bharata was not whimsical in his thoughts of going to the forest to bring back Rama to Ayodhya. Bharata was very serious about this, and therefore he built roads so that the army and everyone could travel safely to the forest. And more importantly, when Rama returns, there is this beautiful path laid down for him. And there is a very interesting point over here as well. In the last verse, Valmiki says, Sachandra Tara Gana Manditam Yatha. It was Sachandra with the moon. Tara means the stars. Manditam Yatha. It was like a procession of stars. It was like a constellation and the moon. And that was how the path was. And it's interesting because when Rama returned, obviously he did not walk the road. He flew through the sky, which was full of stars and the bright moon as well. And therefore, even though Rama did not use the road that Bharata had laid for his return to Ayodhya, Rama chose a method that was very close to the beauty of the road that Bharata laid down for him. The Lord may not fulfill the wishes of the devotees exactly as how the devotees seek for it, but there is always a charm, there is always a beauty in the way the Lord fulfills their devotees' wishes, sincere wishes. And there are lots of technical details in this chapter about how they laid the roads and all the various things that had happened. But we need to understand the crux of the matter is that Bharata was extremely serious about going to the forest. And he definitely wanted Rama to come back. And his actions are proving as strong as his words as well. Mangalam Koshalendraya Mahaniya Gunapdeye Chakravarti Dhanurjaya Sarva Bhaumaya Mangalam.